Coming up on this episode of the Martinville Raceway Report, we will cover the race action from June 28th and June 21st, which happened to be my birthday. We have some special guest analysts from June 21st. We're going to start a new segment this episode where we're going to follow each race. We're going to kind of spotlight a racer, try to get his feedback throughout the whole day to try to give encapsulate his day as I do as far as my opinions between the hot laps and between the heat races, and then from the heat races to the feature, then after the feature, same thing. We're gonna pick a driver, do the same thing. We've got interviews, we've got highlights, we've got information, all that and more on this episode of the Martinville Raceway Report, which starts right now.
It's my
As we continue on here with the Martinville Raceway Report, we're here with Jay Kralik. He is the pit steward here at Martinville Raceway. He's been doing this here at Martinville for 2 years, and we wanted to take this opportunity to let the viewers know exactly what the pit steward does as far as starting the process, the grid, and everything like that, so nobody can ever complain if they've watched this show exactly what is the starting process here at Martinville Raceway. So right now, Jay, I'm going to turn it over to you. Tell us exactly what is the starting process here at Martinville Raceway.
All right. When everybody signs in up at the board up there, the girls will come down, write their class on the board, and they put how many cards are in each class. And on hot laps, they come up, I count, and I divide the classes up. It depends on how many cards are in there. And then we'll send them out for hot laps. And then when it's heat races, the girls would put their lineup here, and then I'll write it on my board here. And then if the carts, each class, I go through the carts. If they're here, I mark them off. They're here, here. Then I tell the flagman up top that they're all lined up, they're all ready to go. And then I send them out. And I do that at feature time. I make sure they're all here before I send them out. And if we got some we gotta wait on, I'll wait on them. They give them two laps, and then after that two laps, it's up to the flagman. When he goes, they go. And if one's up here getting late and they already threw the green, they don't go out. That's what I do. I stay here and make sure the carts go out and don't go out, and make sure they got their helmets, their gloves, their neck collars, make sure they got everything prepared.
Now, being in the infield, taking pictures, stuff like that, I'm able to observe different things that go on, and so for viewers know, you'll see sometimes Jay back here, he'll have his flag and he'll be holding it up in the air. I know what it means, but I'm going to let him explain exactly when he's here in the pit with one flag up in the air, what exactly does that mean?
What I do is when I send some out and there's one ready to go, I'll hold it up. That lets the flagman know I got one cart ready to come out, and as soon as that cart goes, then that's those in that class. Then I take my flag down, and they're lined up. And he throws the green.
I'm there in the infield. I know sometimes we run into questions as far as like the process goes, or as far as are we moving things through quickly and stuff like that. But seeing it from the infield, I know that it's, for lack of a better term, it's a very well-oiled machine. We've got he's here as a pit steward. He's here letting the flagman know, is everybody ready to go? Is there a holdup on anybody? I see him when he waves if there's a holdup, but then for whatever reason the cart can't go out, I see him take that flag and he'll circle it, meaning we're good to go. So he does a great job here at Martinville, and you know what? He's been doing this for many years. He's done it at many racetracks. So let's go ahead and dive into his history. How many different tracks have you been a pit steward at?
Well, I've done Fenley. I started in infield, and then I was the pit steward there, and then I worked my way over to Little Indy, did that for 17 years, and then I did this one for 2 years.
So we're talking about an experience here. Here at Martinville, we've got experience on the flag stand. I think he's been doing it. The flagman's been doing this for years. Obviously, here in the pit steward, we got someone with a lot of experience keeping things organized. There's a system in place. ready to go. So don't ever think when you come here to Martinville, is there a system in place? Do they know what they're doing? Guess what? They know what they're doing. They're veterans here. We keep things going. We keep things hopping. So, Jay, I want to thank you for your time. This is going to be a great instrument as far as instruction goes. So people know exactly when you come here, be ready to go. I mean, they cycle things through. The classes are up on the board. If you have a question, they're here. The board's there. Ask the questions. Get yourself in line. Get ready to go. So, Jay, thank you for the time.
You're welcome.
Thank you for everything you do for go-kart racing, because, listen, he doesn't have to do this, but he does it, and he's here. Race in, race out. He's never missing. When it's time for him to be here, when it's time for him to start the karts, that he's in his place. So let's make sure you're in your place. When it's time for you to go out on the grid, for Jay to start you up. Well, he laps over with here at Martinville Raceway. We're here on my birthday, June 21st. And behind me, we've got so many carts in one pit, it's not even funny. We have the number 7, 305, Brendan Goforth, driving 305 today. We've got Corey Weil in the 22 blue plate. We've got another 22 in the 305 class. Caitlin Woods in the number 30. They're all pitted here in this pit. They're all working on their carts right now. The track seems to be a little bit soft. I've heard people are drifting. I've heard people are pushing. It's not the usual loose to begin here at Martinville Raceway tonight, but it is a fantastic night. There are over 70 entries here for winnings for racing here at Martinville Raceway tonight. It's going to be a great night. The track already has grip. It seems to be a story. It used to be you didn't have grip off the bat. Now all of a sudden, the past three races, you've had grip right off the bat. So maybe the track is changing. It's kind of hard to say. Weather may have had something to do with it, but it's a great start here at Martinville Raceway tonight. It's going to be great to see who is able to make those adjustments, get out front and win. We do know we have a full field in the 305 clone, 12 carts, full field, 12 will make the feature. That's going to be a great race tonight here in the feature, but let's see how the heat races go. Hot laps are over with. Heat races are coming up. It's going to be a great night here at Martinville Raceway. stay tuned to the Martinville Raceway Report. We'll give you an idea who's doing what in the heat races, and we'll see who's going to come out with a feature wins here tonight at Martinville Raceway. The heat races have concluded. They're blowing off the track right now. They're getting ready for the feature races, and it's been a great night of racing so far here at Martinville Raceway. One thing is, there has not been a lot of cautions. There was grip in the track to begin with, and everybody seems to be taking advantage of the grip that's on the track. There's actually two grooves tonight. If you want to go on the high side, you can actually be competitive up there. The preferred line is still down low, but for the first time in I can't remember how long, there's a second line up high that you can run. The Weaver Performance carts seem to be the front runners in most of the classes that they're in. The 24 and the 360 clone and the 305 clone definitely seems to be the front runner. The 98 and the 360 flathead seems to be a front runner. The 51 and the open clones seems to be the man to beat. In the blue plate, Corey Weil, the number 22, he won his second heat race. He seems to be the man to beat. It's been a great night of racing action. I know I'm forgetting a lot of people, but I'm going to introduce my brother Jerry. He's here for the first time at Martinville Raceway. We're out here celebrating my birthday, and he has an observation when it comes to the OWO class. So take it away, Jerry.
OWO, you need to watch, is number 13, Fugitive.
Yes, the Fugitive.
The Fugitive. Yeah, the machine is able to run the inside of the track steady. A consistent performance from the driver. He puts the pressure on you. If you make a mistake, he will exploit it and take your position. He has done it consistently in all four of the heats that four of the matches that he's run. He has been the entertainment of the night.
He's referring to the fact that the number 13 is running both the OWO class and the Opens class. And as Jerry mentioned, the 13 just seems to be biding his time. He puts the pressure on the cart in front of him, and he waits for them to make the mistake. And when they make the mistake, there he goes. Now, I was really impressed with my brother. I had to put him on camera because even during the heat laps, or the practice, when he was out there, he noticed the 13 seemed to have a real good handle on the track. So he was picking the 13 even in even during practice, which was really impressive. Now, as I mentioned, it's been a great night so far here in Martinville. Very little cautions. Hopefully that will carry over into the features. We have a full field in the 305 clone. We've got all 12, so that's going to be a great race. And I cannot forget about Purple Plate. It's pretty much wide open, but I have to give a shout out to Caitlin Woods in the number 30. She started on pole in the second heat race, and her cart just seems to love clean air because she was gone. So look for her in the Purple Plate. The 78 Austin Black, he also seems to be a contender in the 305 clone. And I'm looking out for my boy Brendan Goforth in the 7 Victor Racing Engines car. It's the first time in 2 years that he's been in the 305. With an adjustment, he may be a front runner. So it's been a great night here. I want to thank my brother for being here with me. My mom is also here. It's been a great night. And if you want to find out who won, where points are standing, just continue on as we continue on with the Martinville Raceway Report. We are here in the pits of number 30, Caitlin Woods, who tonight, now a couple weeks ago, she won her first Purple Plate feature here at Martinville, but it was not a points event. Well, guess what? 2 weeks later, she comes out and she wins her first points event at Martinville Raceway. I'm sorry, make that 3 weeks later. So Caitlin, take me through your day. Take me through that feature race. How did you come home with the victory tonight here at Martinville Raceway?
I got a little bit aggressive, and then I spun out, and then I went to the tail, I think.
I went forward.
I went back to fourth, and someone spun me out again.
Yep.
And I went.
Got hit pretty hard.
When you went to the back, that ended up being the final time. You didn't know at the time. What was going through your mind? What were you thinking you had to do to get back to the front?
I had to go under them all or over, just try to get around them.
Now, were you confident that you could do that?
Yeah.
Now, take me through, okay? Let's go back to the beginning of the year, okay? You jump from novice up to Purple Plate, all right? That's a big jump. You're not a lot of experience. You struggled a little bit to begin the year. What has changed between the beginning of the year and now that's getting you into victory lane? What's changed with you? What's changed with the cart? What do you think? What's your opinion on that?
Since I was just starting out in purple, I might have gone a little slower than I was now, but now I'm just going, and I didn't want to hurt myself by passing people.
Okay.
Because I was scared that I would get hit or something.
Okay.
And I was scared that I would get hurt. So now I'm not scared that anything will happen.
Okay, now I'm going to turn to Don, who is the owner of the cart. Same question. Beginning of the year, you guys kind of struggled. But you've been improving week after week after week. Now, you're running with the front runners. To you, what's been the key to get you guys from the back to the front?
The cart ain't changed too much. Actually it isn't handling as good as it was last time we was here tonight. So, I mean, she drove her butt off in that one. She got a little, more aggressive than most people liked at the beginning of that. But she got slammed pretty good, and she surprised me. I'm real proud of her. I can't believe it. So
now
be much happier.
Now I'm in the infield. I get a good bird's eye view of the race, and I can say this: from the beginning of the year to now, she has done a good job as far as changing her line. She's doing more of an apex, allowing herself to carry more speed into the corners and more speed out of the corner. So that's just my personal opinion as far as one thing that has helped her as far as speed goes. But Caitlin, I mean, this is fantastic. You won your first Purple Plate feature a few weeks ago. Even though it was 9 points, it's still a feature win no matter how you look at it. And now you have your first points paying feature win. Big things ahead for you. Big things ahead. So thank you, Caitlin. Thank you, Don. Thanks. And we're going to hear a lot more. We're going to see a lot more from her as we continue this year. We're just bigger and better things. So we thank you guys for joining us with this interview. And we will continue on with the Martinville Raceway Report. Well, that's it, folks. As I'm getting bunny ears from my brother, tonight's over with. The feature races were fantastic. We had a lot of good winners tonight. A lot of people who dominated their feature race. Zach Newman, a 325 flathead, congratulations. You went out there, you dominated your feature. The 51 in the open clone, nobody could touch him. Domination in the feature. Weaver Performance once again had a great night. The 91, the 24 won, and the 98 was very solid in his feature. In the purple play class, Caitlin Woods, two races in a row, she comes home with the feature win. Tonight was a fantastic night. Now earlier we were talking about the 13 and the OWO, and he did run a great race, but the 29 made that adjustment that he needed to keep in front of the 13 in the OWO. It all comes down to adjustments. How do you react to the track? Tonight, the track had plenty of grip. It was almost like Michigan International Speedway. Plenty of options. It doesn't happen often, but tonight was a night where you had options here at Martinville Raceway. Now, we're always talking about how I'm always mentioning on here, if you've never been to Martinville Raceway, you need to come out because you're going to have a fantastic time. Well, guess what? I made him come out because today is my birthday, and that was my birthday present from him. He came out, he joined us tonight, and so as a first timer, I'm going to ask him how he liked it. So, Jerry, how did you like it tonight? I'm telling you, folks, you come out, he's speechless. That's a good thing. You come out to Martinville Raceway, you're going to have a fantastic time. You get to play with family. You get to watch great racing. And most importantly, you get to have a great time. Mom, get in here. This is my mom. If so, anybody who argues with what I do, blame her. It came from her, okay? This is my mom. She also came out for my birthday. And then TJ, get over here, my nephew of mine. This is the tall one. He came out for my birthday. So from Martinville Raceway, we had a great night tonight. We're going to be back at it next week on the June 28th with more fantastic racing from Martinville Raceway. Well, we're here on June 28th at Martinville Raceway, and today is a very hot, muggy day. Today may be the warmest day so far in the young season here at Martinville Raceway. I just got done talking to my son, the driver of number 7 Victory Racing Kart, and he did say that the track does have a lot of grip. So it just seems to be that the track is starting to trend toward having grip out of the gate. It used to be through hot laps and through the first set of heat races, there was not a lot of grip in the track, but it seems like the last four races or so, there's been a lot of grip in the track to begin with. So it'll take probably a couple more races to see if that's a trend or if that's something that's going to go back to the way it used to be. Also, we're going to spotlight a driver throughout tonight's race. Tonight, it's going to be Keegan Schneider, driver of the 99 360 flathead cart. I just got done talking to him, and he says right now that his engine's actually bogging down coming out of the corners, so there's a little bit too much engine grip. So it'll be nice to see what they do to fix that problem. It'll be interesting to see what Brennan does to improve his cart throughout the race. And it'll be interesting to see if there's anybody who gets too tight. Tight is not a word that gets thrown around a lot here at Martinville, but past few races, tight just seems to be coming up more and more often, so we'll wait and see who is able to make what adjustment to keep their cart from getting tight. So the heat races are over with. We're going to be, the hot laps are over with. We'll be starting the heat races here very soon, and it's going to be interesting to see who is able to make those adjustments to get themselves up front in the heat races to position themselves where they need to be to start the feature races to get themselves to victory lane here tonight at Martinville Raceway. Well, the heat laps are done here at Martinville Raceway here on June 28th. And one thing we're learning very quickly is there are not a lot of front runners here tonight. The 24 in the 305 and 360 clone and the 14 in the open clone are about the only clear-cut front runners we have tonight. As you can see, we have a lot of fun going in the background right now. Now, go back to our feature racer tonight, Keegan Schneider, the 99 360 flathead. He thinks he finally got his cart the way he needs it to be so he can make himself a run in the feature. He finished third in his first heat race and fourth in his second heat race, so that'll start him out mid-pack, and he's thinking he's got a long run cart. So if his feature goes green, It's a 15 lap feature. If he can get a lot of green, a long green flag run, he thinks he can come home with the victory tonight here at Martinville Raceway. The heat races went very quickly. As you can see right now, usually when I'm giving you my update between the heat races and the feature, I'm in the dark. Well, I'm not in the dark right now. We're most likely going to start the feature races during daylight hours tonight. So this will be the first time this year that we've gone through so quickly. So in the feature races between nighttime and daytime, it'll be interesting to see if there's any difference. If anybody has a hard time getting the cart the way they want to, daytime compared to nighttime. So as we continue on with Martinville Raceway Report, we'll let you know who won the features here tonight, and we'll give you a points update. We'll update you as far as the upcoming schedule here at Martinville Raceway, and we'll give you plenty of more information. So as we continue on with the Martinville Raceway Report, we'll give you everything you need. That's it for tonight's action here at Martinville Raceway. It was a great night here, June 28th. The racing action matched the weather. Hot and sticky. Big congratulations goes out to the Weaver performance carts of the number 24 and the number 98. Once again, they won both heat or feature races that they were entered in. It was a great night here tonight. The number 14 Open Clone, once again, visits Victory Lane. In the OWO class, number 28, 2 weeks in a row, he visits Victory Lane. Now, we've been talking to Keegan Schroeder all night. Guess what? I had the name wrong. It's Keegan Schneider. The number 99 in the 360 flathead. Now, as I mentioned before, his engine early on was kind of bogging him down, so they were having a hard time getting the car going. But guess what? They made their adjustment, and they had a great feature race. And I'm going to let Keegan tell you all about it. So, Keegan, how was your car in the feature?
Well, my car was pretty good in the feature. For about the first couple laps, it started bogging. But once we got towards the longer run, it stopped bogging out. And we ran about 9.9 second laps, so it's pretty quick. We've only done that a couple times this year, so the track is really fast.
His dad mentioned that 9.9 is the second fastest lap that they've ever run here at Martinville Raceway, and he also told me before the features, he said they have a long run cart, and that's exactly the kind of cart they had, because their feature was caution free, and as the feature race went on, He was matching lap for lap the speed of the 98 who won the feature race. So now this is a kind of like a new segment I want to work with. If you liked us spotlighting a driver, well, let's continue to do this on. Let me know. Leave some comments for me. Now, before we let Keegan go, is there any sponsors that you want to mention?
Yeah, I'd like to mention Tanks Meats out of Elmore, Ohio, along with Vision Quest T-shirt shop out of Elmore, Ohio as well. And I'd also like to thank Genoa's Riverside Machining.
Now, we may not have mentioned Keegan very much on the broadcast so far this year, but let me say this. He's been very consistent, kind of like flying under the radar. Not really up there winning races, but he's right there just waiting to strike. And I very much anticipate seeing Keegan here in Victory Lane before too long. They're making the right adjustments to the cart. They know what the cart's doing, and most of all, they know what the adjustments they need to make to their cart to make their cart run fast here at Martinville. They can adjust to the track. The track had a lot of grip tonight. There was a wide lane. Both front stretches are almost completely black. The track had grip for the taking. He found it in his feature race. A lot of the racers found it in their feature race. It was a great night here at Martinville Raceway. Thank you, Keegan, for stopping by. I'm sorry about butchering your last name in the four segments before this, but we got it right here in the end. So as we continue on with the Martinville Raceway Report, we'll give you a list of some of the winners. We'll try to break down the points race for you and give you an idea on future racing here at Martinville Raceway.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you gotta hang tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around, nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around, and nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
try your best to